It says
Oh,
going
going live.
live.
We're already live.
No, there's
we're
live.
There we
okay,
go.
we're live.
We're live.
You're
Hi.
live.
Hey, everybody.
Thanks to mine. Hello, everybody. Hi, everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers. This is Fred. If you didn't know, that's Fred. Well, no.
Okay.
That's Fred.
That's Meg.
Bring out the Fred.
Carrie.
Bring out your Fred.
Sing.
Oh, Carrie. You should get that 4 from 8. I think you should. Yes.
Oh, yeah. That's a really pretty color.
It is. Oh, and it turns out it wasn't the same one that Fred saw at Newport.
Yeah, that one was a 2015.
Yeah.
So 2015 with a lot of coffee where the steering column was and the knob that was missing. Well, it wasn't missing, but the front bezel was missing, and that just really irked me.
Oh, by the way, the dog is right below me.
Mo is
right
accounted for.
I don't know what he's doing.
Moe Bear.
Mo slept with Fred last night.
I mean, fuck, on the
next
bed.
To Meg.
Next to.
What? That's not even weird.
I snorted.
Yes, he did.
Oh.
Cheers, cheers. Hey. Yes. I hope everyone's drinking or enjoying themselves somehow. Man, we've been doing these quite a few weeks in a row.
Well, I know. We said we would continue them because people liked them during the social isolation, social distancing measures.
Yeah.
So let me tell everybody about Austin.
Oh, yeah. What's your thoughts?
Wow. What a great city.
It's not like you thought Texas would
be,
right?
Oh, no. I mean, really nice, really, you know, really hip. And
Trinidad.
I mean,
wow.
Hey, I wish I was where you are.
Dude, my Quentin is, if you ever go to Quentin TV, his YouTube channel, he's from Trinidad. Really good guy.
Friend of the channel.
Yes. Fred, I need you to go verify its sexiness, please.
No problem. No problem. Oh, by the way, shout out to Sean because I think he's watching this. Sean, if you're there, what's up? I think I know which one you are.
Yeah, let us know which one are you.
Yeah, let us know which one is you. And then we'll
Carrie.
Go to Austin for the cars. Stay for the Meg.
Oh.
Stay for the food. Well, normally, like, oh, my God. So we did our first violation of social distancing, although it was allowed.
It's not allowed. A violation if the city has permitted it.
The city's allowing it. And I will say they had it organized pretty well.
Oh, so there he is. Yeah, Sean. What up, Fred? There he is.
Oh, that is?
That was him.
Oh, yeah.
I told you. So he put it is what it is. That's him.
So believe it or not, restaurants are opening slowly.
In stages.
Yeah. And so are bars, which I'm kind of like, I don't know about bars.
I don't know how you social distance in a bar.
Yeah.
The nature of bars defy social distancing.
Yeah, that's just a, but anyway, so we went to lunch and like we were out on a patio and it was like they had like only a few tables open and the rest were all closed, like they had no seats. And so we sat quite a ways away from any other tables. But it was weird because it's the first time any of us had eaten at a restaurant in like three plus months.
It was surreal.
It was like, oh, wow, are we really doing this?
Yeah.
Are we really allowed?
Well, it felt illicit.
I know. It just was like, wow, I guess we can do this. And we didn't ever feel like we were at risk because all the servers were wearing masks. They all wore gloves.
They put paper versions of the menu in envelopes.
Which
that they
I think
just,
is completely
that was brilliant.
Brilliant.
That was
brilliant.
No, that was
yeah.
smart.
I don't want to touch nasty menus.
Yeah.
They're just disgusting.
No, I think
exactly.
in general you're
even,
right.
Even if there was no coronavirus situation.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Still
yeah.
Nasty.
Just have a throwaway menu that
yeah.
you just, whatever.
There's the menu.
So,
throw it away or, you know.
Yeah. So, hello, everyone. What else can you get? Where else can you get the worst barbecue at gas stations? Yes.
Oh, Carrie.
He has not been to Rudy's yet.
We'll take him.
We'll take him to Rudy's. But tomorrow, we actually are getting the pork chops from Perry's.
Oh, I can't wait for that.
Oh, God.
Oh, hi, GT Pro.
Yes.
Hey, GT Pro.
Fred, why do you prefer a newer F40 over the non-cat version?
Why do I prefer a newer one over the non?
I don't think we have a specific preference on here.
Yeah, is he talking about one without a catalytic converter?
He's saying, why do you prefer the newer ones? Because the later years, they put in the caps.
Oh, like the, okay, are you talking about like the 91 or 92 or something?
Well,
like
the 91 and 92 supposedly had some differences that they changed. I don't know exactly what. They're supposed to be the better car.
Oh, okay.
But they also added the cats in the Euro versions for the later ones.
Oh, okay.
So the early Euros did not have cats.
Okay. Well, I don't really know how to answer that. I don't think we're really looking at it engine-wise as much as
real
we
quick,
are.
Perry's does do delivery.
Oh, cool. All right.
Perry's does delivery. Support your local restaurants.
Yeah, we've already gotten it. It's badass.
It's awesome.
It's so good. Anyway.
They lose nothing in it being delivery. Perry's is still good.
It's still good. Sorry.
Oh, no problem. So anyways, I don't think it's so much of a... I can say this, and maybe some people might get mad at me, but I do want an American car.
The U.S. spec.
Yeah, I want the U.S. spec. I don't want to sit there and look at metric gauges, or even if it doesn't have that bladder for the fuel tank, that's even better.
Well, but from what we've been reading, you still have to change the fuel cells on the U.S. cars.
Well, we'll change
it. They just last longer.
Yeah, with that one
But yeah, you can go to there's an aftermarket.
Yeah.
So we found an aftermarket fuel cell that supposedly is like indestructible. You change it, and then you're done forever.
Right.
So that's something to consider. And also, the one thing to consider is, on buying a cat versus non-cat, you can remove the cats.
Sure. Like, I mean,
so there's no, you know, you get a cat car, yank the cats, and now you have a non-cat car.
Yeah, and then if you have to go, like if you live in California or a place where it has those EPA regulations, which I don't really know anywhere else, but just put it back on, and if you're that worried about it, you know, take it with it and get it smoked.
Anyway, someone was asking, I thought you found one in Japan. We had. So we're going to get to the current status in a second. We're kind of waiting for more people to get here, so we don't have to tell the story five times.
You will anyway.
Yeah, we're going to have to tell it five times.
Okay, so why don't you start with the F8 thing that Fred is talking about.
Yeah, we have an F8 update.
Yep, so I got a call from the general manager of Ferrari on Newport Beach. Whose nephew watches this channel. I'll say hi to him if he's watching it. I don't know him by name, but that's cool. He even found out that we were looking for an F40.
Yeah.
And he offered his, but I think that one is just a little too expensive. Anyways, long story short, they said that I have my allocation and they are ready to start taking the specification for it. And they are going to place the order for it by the end of this year, and I should have it if things go well. Hopefully, you know, the COVID things don't flare up and it's Italy again.
Are the factories still closed?
Yeah,
they're back in business.
Oh, they reopened the factory.
I shouldn't have said that. Does that demonetize them?
No.
Okay. You can use it loosely.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
YouTube has loosened up on COVID because it's hard to avoid people talking about it.
Yeah. It's impossible because
it's in our society.
Right.
So anyways.
At first they were sensitive because people were saying they were
making up crap. They were like, drink bleach.
Deep. Yeah.
I should probably not say that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just horrible. Yeah. So anyways, long story short, he said I should see a car within 6 to 8 months, which is not bad. And I didn't think that this was going to happen too. I mean, because it's really difficult to get these cars. It's not easy.
No.
Yeah. I mean, it's a lot easier to buy them used, but it's a lot of building relationships and work.
Ferrari's got it down. It's going to make it makes you feel like you're lucky to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars to wait a year or a year and a half for a car.
Yeah,
that's part of their whole plan.
Yeah.
I mean, that's part of the whole.
That seems like no other industry on earth. Other commodity do they make you wait that long when you're like,
purses.
I have several hundred.
Yeah, like any.
Like
Michael Jordan shoes.
Or Trico Field. Have you heard of Trico Field?
No.
That's that one purse manufacturer that only makes about 3 or 4 purses a year.
3 or 4.
The reason I wasn't thinking of that.
I actually remember there's a beer that was made by these monks.
Yeah.
And they only made a specific amount of beer a year.
No kidding. Wow.
And you had to like get on the list to get the beer. And so people would sell the beer for like thousands and thousands of dollars.
Oh, my
goodness. And it was like what? Because supposedly it's like the best beer. Anyway, I remember reading this article.
Yeah.
Because they only produced a very, very, very limited quantity of this beer.
Wow. And it's very expensive.
No, they would sell it at a reasonable price.
Oh, really?
But then people would like resell it.
Okay, someone just said custom yachts are a year wait. Well,
Oh, yeah.
That's like building a house.
That's because it takes a while to build them.
Yeah, they are. Yeah, so anyways, yeah, so it's a little bit of a process. And, you know, they only – the thing is here is that they only make so many. They're not production line vehicles. They only make so many. And they like to cater to the people who are their customers, who appreciate the brand and buy
them. Well, the thing is, it's actually a bit of brilliant marketing.
Yeah, it is.
So, like, when you make people – like, Ferrari has a history of artificially increasing demand by purposely not making as many cars as there are demand.
Right.
So, if the demand's here, Ferrari is always here. And as it increases, they just go like this, right? They just stick with that. Mm-hmm. So Ferrari always, always, always will make less cars than people want to buy it.
Right.
And there's always going to be people who cannot buy the car they want from Ferrari.
Right.
Because that makes it like this mysterious, like, oh my God, I got to get it, like kind of attitude, right? And it's actually brilliant when you have a low quantity, high margin product like Ferrari.
Sure, absolutely. And it's good.
Yeah, yeah. So like, yeah.
I mean, it's just so awesome.
Yeah. I've seen a lot of people are asking
a question.
What cars do you own?
Oh, okay. Well, I have a 458 Spider 2015.
You have a van.
I got a van. I got a lot of vans. But, let's see. I have a lot
ton of VWs.
Yes, I have a ton of VWs.
How many?
Which is cool.
Like seven total.
Seven VWs.
Yeah, and about four of them that are drivable. So, yeah, the rest of them are like either you don't want to drive them or you know, they're not in a condition to drive.
There's probably a big YouTube audience for that shit. I can't believe you don't have a channel based on having shop.
There's definitely VW people.
Yeah, there is, but...
why isn't Scott here? Scott's like, Brett's my guy.
Yeah. We'll probably see him next week. Yeah. Anyways, yeah, VWs are cool.
Josh is there.
Hey, there's Josh, our guru of gurus.
Yes.
And hi to Rachel next door. Hey, Rachel hung out with us all night last night.
Oh, she's a blast. Oh, man, I love
her.
She's
still stuck on the artillery shelves.
Oh, look. I've got the keys to Kent's truck. I love that. Hey, you guys got to do it.
No.
Dan's like, no.
We already been in trouble. We already caused a lot of trouble.
God.
Let's see. Andre says the F8 is a phenomenal car. It is such an evolution from the 458 to the F8. Are you getting the F8 at FNB? Yes.
Yeah.
I personally enjoy doing business. Yeah, Tim. Tim is an awesome guy. People either really love him or they don't. And I think the looky-loos are the ones that don't.
Well, sure. Yeah. I have to say, Ferrari of Newport was really solid.
Yeah. Well,
they were solid. And like,
yeah, they know us.
Here's the thing about going to Ferrari dealerships and like, I get it. Like, I would not want to be a Ferrari salesperson because you get so many people who are just tire kickers looking to get a joyride.
Yes.
And so actually, I'm friends with a couple of the salespeople at Ferrari of Austin, and they told me, they're like, look, the guy that comes in all dressed up in a suit is not buying a Ferrari today.
Right.
They're there to try and impress me so that we can go for a joyride, and they ain't going to buy anything.
Yeah.
The guy who pulls up in an F-350 wearing cowboy boots, like crappy shorts and a t-shirt is the guy who's going to buy a Ferrari in cash because they have so much money. They say, I don't give an F. I can buy what I want.
Right.
Oh my God. Kevin is asking Rachel about Kent's mom and David Hasselhoff. We didn't even bring it up.
Yeah.
Oh man.
We got some true fans here.
Wow. That is so funny.
And Rachel's been on a live stream before. We have to have Kent over here. To defend his mother's honor eventually.
Well, look, we have to get all of the little things out of the way. So we got that out of the way. Now let's talk about the livery walk.
No.
So Fred is going to get an F40 and then he's going to liberty walk.
Yeah. Oh my God. I would shoot somebody.
People would come seriously kill you.
Oh shit. Yeah.
They would be like, where is he? We're going to kill him.
It's great content though. Great content.
Oh yeah. A Meg review of the F40 would be wicked. Yeah, it would.
If Fred wants me to do that with his automobile, it will happen. I won't be driving it, guys. I don't like, we've talked about this before.
Shh, Mark. No, no.
What did Mark say?
No.
What did he say?
I'm not going to mention it.
Oh, okay.
We're not going to mention it.
But where is it on the screen?
Oh, any info on your F8 spec so far? So what are you thinking?
Oh, okay.
So what's his thoughts on the spec?
Meg, sorry. Exterior color yellow. Yeah, so I'm going to get...
It's not my house car. It's not my incredibly expensive car. I'm not buying it. Yeah.
Okay, so exterior color is going to be Jello Modena. Interior.
It's
Jello?
Modena.
Jello. You got to say Jello Modena.
Jello Modena.
Like lemon Jello.
It's Yellow Modena.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yellow Modena. Yeah, Modena, yellow, whatever. So, yeah, the exterior is going to be yellow. Definitely Nero interior. Possibly yellow stitching. That's Loper. I loved it.
I didn't convince you on the blue.
You know, I have to see it.
Let's
see if they have it in the specification. And
we need to find Alex from Ferrari of Austin, or any of the people from Ferrari of Austin who saw the. It was actually triple yellow metallic. It was not yellow made it. You know, Jello Medina.
Oh,
but it was
Jello Medina.
It was the coolest. It was the coolest yellow I've ever seen in person, and they did a blue seats with yellow stitching and a yellow Cavallino.
Oh, wow.
And like, I think they may have had yellow stripes, like yellow Daytona stripes or something in it. No, it was yellow vertical stripes.
Then it had to have been the race seats, huh?
Yeah, yeah. It was the race seats.
Which the race seats are less comfortable.
Depends.
Yeah.
The carpets, it depends. For long drives, yes.
The bad part about the race seats.
They're not as adjustable.
Yeah, they're not, and they're not electric.
Nowhere near. Yeah, and they're not electric.
They're all manual.
That's BS. No race seats. Yeah. Not for this type of car.
But it was yellow.
The regular ones are comfortable.
Yellow was blue, but it was a bright metallic yellow. Oh. And the blue was like this, I've never seen anything. It's a softer blue. It's not this dark.
Oh, okay.
It's much lighter.
Yeah, you know what? I think they did have that in this.
I need to look it up. If anyone's got pictures of it, feel free to send them. But it's badass.
So I like the.
Andrew said it sounds like someone Walmart Wolverine would drive. It does sound like U of M colors, maize and blue.
You're right. That's probably why I liked it so much.
Maybe it is.
I mean, I did go to the University of Michigan.
Oh, well, there you go. Maize and blue. Those are the colors. Yeah.
Well, that probably is why I liked it, because I saw it and I'm like, normally I don't like yellow, but I was like, damn, that is that's badass.
So the rims, I'm just going to get whatever they offer standard. I'm not going to get crazy with it. I'm not going to do the Nero roof. I'm just going to do the carbon fiber package.
What's a Nero roof?
The black roof.
Black roof.
Yeah. It's going to be convertible, of course, because I love convertibles.
It's the Spiner.
Yeah. And it's I'm going to get the carbon fiber package, the suspension lift,
reverse cameras, are
reverse
standard
cameras.
Now.
Yeah. The parking sensors and probably the upgraded sound package.
And the shift lights.
And the shift light. And I might consider getting the little GUI for the passenger side. Yeah.
It's expensive.
I don't
What's
care. I think that's like
so cool. They have a new option where the passenger side has a little screen of their own. So it's a touch screen, so you can actually control the stereo and
I think it's monitor only, isn't it?
Nope.
Oh, it actually controls.
Yes.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
You can see what it's like climate control stuff.
Everything. Control the climate control. It can control the radio, the navigation. Yeah. But you can also pull up the stats so you can see how fast you're going, how many RPMs you're doing.
That's sweet.
It's pretty
really
cool. It's actually pretty cool.
Wheels, so standard stock, but I think I'm going to do what Loper did. I'm probably going to get those custom rims that he has, like the 22s and the 21s. Yeah, with that drop, I think that looks sweet. And definitely going to change out the exhaust.
Yes.
Yes.
We're going to make it loud.
With an S line. And
if they make that.
Yeah.
We'll try and work on that.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. I'll pull out the one that's
we'll
in there.
We'll find someone.
Well, we'll just ship it to them and have them do it.
I bet you Fab Speed's gonna make one.
Yeah, maybe if they do it, that'd be cool. I'd buy that.
Hey, Fab Speed.
Hey, Fab Speed.
Shipping you my F8 exhaust. So you
there
can
you go.
Copy it. Don't All tell right. Ferrari.
What do I think about a 2012 Gallardo LP550-2 with under 30,000 miles for $96,000? Do you think they will depreciate more, especially considering the economic climate? I mean. It's going to depreciate more. I don't know how much more. I think Gallardos are starting to get near the bottom of the barrel. The reason I think it's going to depreciate more is I've seen them as cheap as like $60,000.
Gary Loper's wife won't be happy. Okay. That's okay.
Yeah. Loper's wife will give you crap. So I don't know. I think my personal thing on the Gallardos is that I personally just don't like the look of them. But if you like the look of them, they're good cars. There's nothing wrong with them. They're great cars. But I think they will depreciate some.
Russ Pelt Fred, the mysterious multi-million dollar man. I'm about $1 million shy of being a millionaire. I work very hard for my money.
That's my world.
Yeah. Yeah, we work really hard for our money. And, you know, we just, you know, if you're a good, savvy business person and you're good with your customers, your clients, and build something up, you can do well in life, too.
Stephen Perez thinks you're handsome, Dan.
Dan, he's mansome.
I'm mansome.
Yes, so.
We're drinking this tonight. I don't know what this is.
Dan, I think this is one he brought home because someone gave it to him. It's French wine.
We don't ever buy French wine.
So we ended up with this, and I said, what is this? And I said, okay, we'll drink that.
We're kind of stepping out of bounds here, drinking some frog wine.
Looks like the 458 is the best bang for your buck. I mean, that's an opinion. I'm sure Dan thinks it is. It depends what...
Well, no, I really actually think the $430 dollar for fun is hard to beat.
Dollar for fun.
Yeah, because it's under $100,000 easily for a coupe, and it's a hell of a car. And they're pretty much not going to depreciate anymore, and they don't require that much maintenance. So the 458, I think, is a better car, and if you can afford it, go for it. But it's, on average, like at least $50,000 more than a 430. So that's 50% more expensive. That is a huge jump in price to go from the 430 to the 458. But I would say that huge gap comes with that much better of a car. And also the 430 is very analog. So if you're an analog kind of person, you will enjoy the 430 more than you will the 458. The 458 is a much more modern supercar with the dual clutch transmissions, you know, lightning fast shifts.
Oh, yeah.
But that's what makes it also kind of amazing.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Yeah. That transmission is awesome.
Yeah.
And it only gets better from there. 488 has an even better one.
Yeah.
F8 is even better. It just keeps getting better.
The thing
and
that
better.
I don't like is, like, I think the 488, they started making the traction control too numb.
Yeah.
Know?
Yeah.
Where, like, in the 458, when you stab the gas, the car gets squirrely, especially if you're in race mode, right? So, like, you don't feel like you're going to die, but you do have to, like, play and fight the steering wheel and actually work at it. The 488 is so sophisticated, you can just get in the car and go, nah, and stab the gas, and it just,
well,
off it goes.
I'm going to have you give it the beans at Coda. We're going to put this, because I
so
told,
that's where
I
those cars
you, yeah,
really,
yeah,
that's going to be fun.
I told Dan, I said, you know, I think the thing, like, totally lets you drift and corrects everything for you. And he's all like, well, there's a certain place that I would actually do that. And I'm like, yeah, and I'm on Coda.
Yeah.
Wait, give it the names. Which car is going to Coda?
The F8
and the F40, both.
Yeah. Softly.
Yeah.
Softly,
no,
F40.
I really.
Yeah.
Well,
what it's for?
Well, but I mean, let's be real. You're not going to be, like, hitting threshold braking at every corner in the F40.
Well,
because you're not going to be like, oh, good, my 1987 brakes are going to really keep me alive.
Oh,
coming,
yeah. Well,
hot,
yeah, okay.
Coming hot into 12, turn,
yeah,
12.
Yeah, okay. You obviously can't treat it the way that you do the F8, but
no,
or even the 458. But
yeah,
I mean, you got to have a little bit of fun.
Yeah. Someone asked, have I ever driven a gated F430? Actually, no, but I've driven a gated 430 Scuderia. So effectively the same thing. Although not really, because the transmission, the 430 Scuderia, is the SF2 transmission, which has different synchros and different clutch disc packs and stuff. So it's actually much, much smoother than a regular 430.
Yeah, I've driven a gated 355, and it was really nice, really clicky, really responsive. Yeah.
Is that Jeff's car?
Well, his is not gated.
Yeah, he has the F1.
He's got the F1.
I don't know what that means.
It's got the flappy paddles.
Oh, those were early flappy paddles.
That was the first Ferrari with the flappy paddles.
I don't remember because I didn't drive his car. Did I?
Yeah, you did.
Yes, I did. Sorry, guys. It's been a long quarantine.
Yes. Thoughts on the second gen NSX now approaching 100K, a lot of performance and tech. I know it's going to sound bad. I just never really cared for the NSX. I actually like the original NSXs. A little bit. I drove one. It is what it is. I'm not that impressed with it. They're not that, like, they're not high horsepower cars, but the newer NSXs, they never excited me. It just, I don't know. Like,
he's unexcited.
Yeah. They just kind of never really did it.
Shame on you, NSX.
Is it like a V6 Ford Mustang?
Yeah, that was, I drove the EcoBoost Mustang just the other day, and it's like, yeah, you need the V8. You really do.
It's very meh.
Yeah. Because, like, it's such a good platform with the
V8.
Yeah. Like, the V8 Mustangs, the new GTs are badass. And you're like, this is a sweet car. And then,
well, it's like the difference. I'm going to talk about your car, Sean. He had the V6. Gosh, I forgot what it was. It was a Dodge.
Challenger? Charger.
Charger. It was a Dodge Charger. It was a V6. He wanted to and that. I said, just go out and get
you
get
need the Hemi. 8. You need the Hemi.
So when he got the Hemi, he put a supercharger on it. That thing was as fast as snot. It was beautiful. Mm-hmm. I mean, he couldn't keep the wheels from spinning. Yeah.
Hell
but it was nice. He did a good job.
What about NXS? Are you ready for the new sensation?
Yes. They're a good band.
Yes, I am. All right. How many miles does my 458 have now? It has 34,000 something, I think. It'll probably have 36 by the end of the weekend.
Yeah, and it runs like a watch.
Yeah, it's good.
It is so nice.
Well, so funny quick story. So we were taking the 458 out for a drive today. And, you know, if you saw the video from yesterday, I think it was yesterday. Yeah, when we did the belt and spark plugs on Richard's car. So we were going to do the belt on my car, but Richard's car had some issues. So we didn't do the belt on my car. Well, funny enough, we went out to lunch, and when I started up the car at lunch, my belt squealed. And I was like, oh, we got to change that belt. So we drove. I called up Richard. I'm like, Richard, is your lift available? Because we need to change my belt. And he's like, yes. So we drove over to Richard's today, and we changed the belt on my car because I'm like, we're not about to go drive 1,000 miles out in the middle of nowhere this weekend and have my belt fling off.
Gosh, that would be horrible. And you can't go to an auto zone to get that belt.
I mean, you might be able to find one if you got the right distance.
Oh, yeah, you're probably right.
Did you get that from Rickambi?
I think he did.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, so I got a new belt, but we didn't film it. We just like quickly in and out changed it just to get it so that we're good to go for the weekend. The 458 has a timing chain. This is the accessory belt that runs the power steering pump, the AC compressor, the alternator, that stuff.
It's run off the harmonic balancer.
Yeah, off the crank.
Yeah.
Oh, someone asked again, Fred, what cars do you currently have?
I have I'm only going to talk about the Ferraris. I'm not going to talk about the VWs, but I have a 2015 458 Spider.
And a lot of VWs.
And a lot of VWs. A lot
and a
of
van.
Classic. And a van. Yeah.
Yes, van.
Yeah, there you go.
What do you think? We got 175 people. We could probably give the F40 update now.
Oh, okay.
So, F40 update.
Okay, so.
First of all, let me tell you, from the perspective of trying to buy an F40. So basically, Fred said, you know, help me find this car, right? And so Omar and I, now Omar is basically in. Omar's in on this. And
Omar is committed.
He is
fully invested.
He is legit. Omar has been fully invested.
He has been awesome.
And it's taken a ridiculous amount of effort just to buy a car. And it's so strange because buying this car is not like buying a regular car. This is far closer to like buying a house.
Yeah.
No, because buying a house is way easier from what I've observed.
It's easier. Yeah, actually, it might be.
Yeah, I don't think it's a fair analogy.
It's you know what it is? It's like buying a house, but you don't know where the house is, and you can't actually see it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And everybody's like, we got this sweet house.
Yeah, we got this sweet house.
I'm not going to tell you where it is.
And it's $1.5 million.
Yeah.
And we swear to God, it's really okay. Cool. It's really good.
Well,
here's
another thing, too. Yeah. You can't take your house on a joyride and crash it.
Yeah.
It can burn up.
It's
or something can happen to it, but it's just a
so
very
frustrating.
It's like a very intangible.
So like no one tells you, no one will tell you any details about the car. They won't give you the VIN.
Yeah.
They won't tell you. They won't send you pictures. They just tell you a price, miles, and if it's U.S. or Euro. That's about it.
Yeah.
And they might tell you what country it's in.
Yeah.
And mind you, I know nothing about any of this, so I find it fascinating. I feel like Margaret Mead is an anthropologist in another culture, somewhere in the jungle. But from what I have observed, if you buy a house of a comparable price to this particular car, the agent will be like, hell yeah, it's available. Come see. I'm going to send you 600 pictures, and let's schedule a viewing.
Right.
Come
total
see my
opposite.
Shit.
Yeah.
So like,
my language.
So, like,
They're not motivated.
Yeah.
They're so, very, hey, okay, fine. You buy
I think
buy
we're on our, no yeah. well. I want to say we're on our third car yeah. that we've been serious about now.
Yeah.
And that's fallen through. So, so we had, the first car we really got serious about was the Japanese import that was in Europe.
Yeah.
That was an LM conversion. And then we kind of decided, you know what, we don't trust not being able to see the car.
Yeah.
And that was the point at which Fred was like, I'm drawing a hard line in the sand. We have to be able to see the car. And that, you know, that makes sense. So we basically said, okay, it has to be in the U.S. because right now we can't go fly anywhere to go check out a car. You know, if...
Oh, there's Omar.
Yeah, Omar's... Yeah.
Omar! Hey, honey!
What's up, Omar?
$1.2 million junior bacon cheeseburgers. So, we were really hoping that was the car, and that kind of fell through. So then we said, okay, let's look in the U.S. And we found what we thought was the great car we wanted. LM conversion, U.S. spec, in the U.S., great miles, supposedly has a good history, lots of recent maintenance, blah, 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 blah. Cool. So we're really excited about this
car. But we're not going to give you anything to verify any of that.
But it was like pulling teeth to get any information on the car. So we didn't know where it was. First, we were like, oh, it's in Florida. We're like, great. Cool. Then they're like, no, it's in Connecticut. And we're like, all right, that's a lot farther, but
it's
cool.
Like they're selling something they don't even know what the location
right.
is.
And we're like, can we get a picture? And they're like, no, we don't have any pictures yet. And we're like,
surely you have pictures. You yeah. liar. Everyone, every last one of these F40s has been photographed.
Right. So like finally, after like we even made an offer on the car. We straight up made an offer. Just to try and get them to be serious and see if we wanted this car. And it took a week after the offer to finally get information about the car. And at that point, we found out it's not an LM conversion. Yeah. Even though we were told it was an LM conversion. We're like, no, it's actually got LM brakes and LM suspension, but it's not an LM conversion. We're like, well, that's not the same thing. And then we found out, turns out this car's like not good. Excuse me, burp.
Yeah,
it's been like beat on. Oh, by the way, it's not actually in Connecticut or Florida. It's in Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
And we're like, well, son of a bitch.
Yeah.
So
and it's been really heavily tracked.
It's been heavily tracked.
Which, I mean, it's a it's race
not
car.
And at the end of the world.
Yeah, that's what we're gonna go
but,
do.
But for what they were asking, the price was way out of bounds.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We were off by like, and our offer was based on us not knowing a lot of data. So as soon as we found out new data, we're like, no, we're not going to give you that offer. That's way too high.
Retracted.
No, yeah.
So retracted.
We were off by like $200,000. So we're yeah. like, no, that ain't going to happen. There's no way the gap's going to merge.
Yeah.
And frankly, at that point, we're like, we're going to have to spend a crap load of money to bring this car up to
snuff. Yeah. And not only that, when you start financing, I mean, I have no problems telling people I'm financing a good portion of it. When you start financing portions of this car, and it's so expensive, they don't just require a PPI. The vehicle has to be appraised.
Yeah.
Because when they're going to give you money for something that expensive, they want to make sure that, one, you're not taken off with the money.
Right. Yeah. yeah. Here's $1.2 million. Yeah, yeah. Peace out.
And the car doesn't even exist.
Yeah. Peace out.
Let's just make sure this isn't a totaled or messed up F40, because if Fred doesn't make the house payments, if practically.
It is.
Yeah. If Fred doesn't make the payments. We want to be able to resell this vehicle. And these cars have a very soft market.
Well, it's a hard market.
It's a hard market.
And let me tell you, we can say that, like, straight up dealing with the, like, there's just so much weird, shady crap. It's
yeah.
just so
and,
hard.
And, you know, this whole situation that happened recently didn't help. You want to go apply for a loan. People sit around for a week.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not their fault. They don't have the labor. They don't have the, you know, the employee power in order to be able to get it done.
So anyway, as we sit, we have two particular cars we're interested in. We're kind of in a like soft hold at the moment. So hopefully we'll get more progress on that shortly. As it stands, an F40 will happen at some point.
Definitely.
Yeah. So it's for sure going to happen. I think we got kind of, frankly, pissed off at the situation. It was very frustrating. And so we kind of took a step back and said, all right, hold on. Let's reassess the whole thing. Let's really understand what we're doing.
Right.
Let's make sure we're getting the right cards. Because frankly, we're all learning on the fly. Like you're learning, I'm learning, mm-hmm. Omar's learning. We're all learning on the fly. None of us have any idea what the hell we're doing. We're all learning as we go.
Sure.
And let me tell you, it is.
And once we start taking it apart too to do some DIYs, we're going to learn even more.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and so you know, it's like, and the problem is like, 1F40, you'll like look at the papers on it, and you're like, okay, this makes sense. This one should be really valued highly.
Right.
How much is the one in Newport?
1.5.
1.5.
That's kind of high.
It's high, and that's the problem. It's, yeah. It's about between $1.5 million and $200,000 too much compared to what we've seen. So like we've dug up, Omar has personally dug up over 25 cars. I got submitted over 26 cars. So in total, we have now well over 50 F40s that we've been looking into. And ranging from on the low side, $900,000 all the way up to $1.8 million. And then a few that were just crazy, like two, and there was one that was six, and just crazy shit. We're like, no.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, a lot of these vehicles that are on display in consignment that are showpieces, or they think it's showpieces, these guys, they got to make their nut, their commission.
Right.
So they're
going
to up the price about 20, 30. And let's face it. I mean, somebody who's going to walk into the showroom floor at Ferrari in Newport Beach and be serious about possibly buying that car, and they're going to possibly be somebody that doesn't really know a lot and just wants to floss.
Yeah.
You know, and pay that price. But somebody who knows the value of a car?
No. Yeah. Yeah. As soon as you know, once you start really understanding the F40 market, you look at the car in Newport and you're like, no.
Yeah.
It's too expensive.
Yeah.
There's way better cars for less money.
Yeah.
And that's what it really comes down to is now we're seeing all these cars and we can start comparing them and say, okay, this car has a perfect history. It's Classic K certified. It has the red book. Blah, 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 blah. It should be worth around this much based on these miles.
Omar's
yeah,
guy
it's
right.
Exactly.
Omar's guy right.
Everyone who is actually selling them says they actually sell at 1.1 or 1.2.
Yeah.
And so then that's the other crazy part is like you look at one car and it's like marked up way, way more. And it's because the brokerage firm or the commission or whatever is like $100,000 on this car. So like legit, someone is skimming off $100,000 off the top of this car in profit just to sell that car. And you're like,
yeah.
What? Like what? You know,
for a...
Yeah, no, that all seems sketch AF.
But that's like that is
sketch
how
AF.
It is, but that's how the market works.
It yeah.
Is,
it's
practically criminal.
But Meg, to protect the salesperson, they usually don't make the sale in 2 minutes.
No, it is a lot of work.
Very long
as Omar has proven, it takes a lot of work.
Now, Omar, you know. Bless your soul. You really put a lot into this. And
Omar,
I know
honey,
this.
You have.
We know this. So.
Yeah, exactly. As Omar said, there's 20 people in the food chain and everyone wants a slice of the pie.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's the weird thing. It's all of us little guys trying to like skim off of you.
Let's face it. Once you start going, and buying these expensive cars, they're very political. It's a political situation. You can't just walk in and say, oh, hi, I'm friend Dan, and we're going to buy this car.
Well, you can if you give them 1.8.
Yeah, if you get what you want.
You can walk into the Newport with 1.5 and you're good to go.
But once you have someone like Dan who knows Ferraris, they're like, oh,
that's the problem. Is like as soon as you are trying to not get screwed
and
really understand what you're doing, then it becomes more and more complicated. The more we learn, the harder it
is. Just like that one guy that tried to knock you out of the loop. I'm not going to mention any names, but someone tried to knock him out of the loop. And I emailed him back and I said, look, you want to know something? No. You talk to Dan. You don't talk to me.
Hey, Jeff.
Hey, what's up, Jeff?
Hey, Jeff.
At the end, everyone is super drunk. Probably.
Probably.
That's the goal. All right? We will destroy this bottle.
We are going to
probably
open it.
Oh, I should probably order a food.
Dude, like, you know what? You know why everything seems so alien to me? Because, like, my career, I spend a lot of time
ordering dinner.
Just trying to get to the bottom of, it's like, how are you? Can I help you self-actualize? What do you want out of your life, really?
Yeah.
Not your parents, not your, you know, spouse. What do you want? I want to know that, and I want to know, and I'm totally non-judgmental. I don't have an agenda for you. This is a safe space. And sales guys are the antithesis of all of that.
Yeah, they are. They really ride on your
They
emotions.
Have an agenda.
Oh,
they're trying to manipulate you.
Mate, there's always someone bidding against you.
Absolutely.
Oh, there's this guy. He really wants this car.
Well, dude, so this was like it's like the more we learn and also the more relationships we build, the more we find out. So the car that we were interested in that we thought was the LM car that wasn't in the US, it turns out the guy was like, thought he had multiple bidders, but it was all us. So like he legit thought he had three. He's like, I've got three people interested in this car. And the problem was it was us because of like we cast out this wide net to the internet. And so people on our behalf were contacting this guy.
Yeah.
So the guy thought he had three separate bidders and all three of them were us. And he's like, well, I'm not gonna come down price because I got three bidders. And we're like, and like finally the one guy we're dealing with is like, I figured it out. It's all you.
Like, oh shit! Like, hey, you should tell me. It's not like I was trying to impersonate other people.
No, like this was totally on accident, yeah. And it's just like, oh god damn it! So like,
absolutely,
it is so frustrating. Like this is worse than it is worse than
my. Oh, house. Jeff, so like, what's the F40 story?
Yeah,
Jeff, I will give you a personal rendition of it tomorrow at lunch. How's that sound?
Oh, yes. The normal guy entourage will be in force at Perry's tomorrow.
Yes, for the pork chops.
Yes.
It will be a sight to behold.
And applesauce.
So anyway,
pork chops and applesauce.
Yeah.
As you can see, it's been just weird. It is so
bonkers.
It is. It's a totally strange world.
It's weird, guys. Yeah,
so I will say one thing. There was this moment, like when I first started, I'm like, I don't understand why people who are really rich pay other people to do this. Now that we're this far in, I'm like, I completely understand why people who are rich pay other people to do this because it is a pain in the dick. And they're like, I don't want to deal with that bullshit. You go find me a car. Here's some money. Go find it. Take care of it. Bye.
Yeah.
Because it's a pain in the ass.
It's a lot of labor.
And then a rich guy's like, I'm going to go purify myself. And
yoga in my
go do my car broker stuff.
Looper!
Hey, there's Chris.
Yay.
I can't wait to shoot a tank with you, Mitch, this weekend.
Hello. Yes. Exactly. Yes, it, exactly. Chris, then they have the money to not deal with the bullshit. That is 100% accurate. And nothing is worse than a pain in the dick. I agree.
And look, it's even having a consultant like Dan, it's you don't have to be filthy rich to do it. I really, if you're gonna go and get a purchase of Ferrari, I really recommend that you take this man with you.
Thanks, Ray.
Because I mean, seriously, you've seen things, you point out things I don't even see. I don't even know about
the car. Thing that is interesting is I'm doing this a lot now.
Yeah.
So I keep like I've done this many, many times. So I keep learning and learning and learning. I'm able to dispense that knowledge.
Right. If it wasn't for him, I probably would have went and bought that $1.5 million car at Newport Ferrari.
Which is not the end of the world, but you would be. Yeah.
I would have asked for something off. I don't just go pay sticker price. I mean, but he would have probably looked at me and said, yeah, maybe no or whatever. But he did say in the email that he's willing to deal.
Which I think we should give him an offer.
Well, yeah. I mean, why not? I mean, it was a nice car.
It is. It's a beautiful car.
This is the most transparent, like, F40 purchase that ever happened. Because it's so, like...
Yes, it is.
Yes.
No, 100%.
And you know what?
It must be.
There's a crew of people that appreciate it. And I'm sure there's people that are chastising us and saying, how the hell do you think you are?
Because we're exposing how stupid the whole thing is.
Don't pull back the velvet curtain. which is entirely just insane shit.
Yeah.
There's nothing mysterious or special going on here. There's just a lot of people who want to make money.
And the craziest thing is it's all about who knows who.
Right.
It's just literally, I've got the biggest Rolodex, therefore I can make the most money on this.
Right.
Did you try to buy the F40 in a wreck? That is not a thing.
No.
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 We don't want.
If I'm not going to buy one in the UK, I certainly sure not going to buy one.
We want to buy one that actually exists and is real.
Oh damn! Snap.
Sorry, I was being a dick.
What?
What does LM mean? Oh, I don't actually know.
Large motor. No, it doesn't have a large motor.
It's just something to do with it was one of the ones that was a race version.
It's probably something Italian.
Yeah, I'm sure it's like
whatever. I don't know.
Limoncello.
Like, yeah. If you want to find out for us because exactly.
I've never looked it up, but Le Mans.
Okay,
that makes sense.
Yeah.
That is it.
Yeah.
Haha, no black wheels in the F40. Kind of like the black wheels.
Look, Loafer, I'm gonna get your same rims on my F8. on the FAA. I love that look.
He's going to drive him by your wife's house so she can just validate that she thinks they're awful.
Yay. Our order is in.
Cool. Yep.
Oh, here we go. Honestly, no, oh, Jeff's talking about something else.
Oh, okay. Yes. HRE P101s all day. Yes. It's probably the same bolt pattern, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, he didn't buy an F8. He's going to buy an F8. He just got his allocation.
Just got it.
And dude, the F8 is badass. I love it.
But we're gonna do a video. I'm gonna fly Dan out.
We're gonna
do a video on specification.
Madam Mam's, Rachel. We're getting Madam Mam's tonight.
We're getting Thai food.
Thai food again, because we're boring.
Jeff said, get them 1 inch smaller, though, Fred. Loafer's just a bit too big.
True.
You know, Jeff, you can judge a man by the size of his rims.
Yeah.
Carrie, I see a red car and a barn down the road. It would be...
Could be an F40.
It could be an F40.
75 grand.
I'll go take a picture of it for you.
Seriously, that's how it is. It's crazy.
Yeah. It's like they're not very driven cars.
Oh, someone said they haven't seen my wig in a long time. Yeah, I know. It's
hot. It's over there.
It's so hot to wear it.
You guys want to see the wig.
Oh, the wig.
No, it's so hot.
Well, we're going to call him the judge.
The judge.
Oh, there it is.
There we go.
There it is.
Dan's wig is the fourth member of the live
stream. It's its own entity now.
Yeah.
Oh, it has its own realm.
You want your wig?
Oh, no one's asked about Mo. I should probably show Mo.
He's having a good time.
They have. You guys were just answering questions about cars.
Mo looks like he's dead. He's
taking a siesta.
Oh, whoops. My monitor is in the way. There he is.
Moe Bear.
There's Mo.
Mama!
Mo Bear. Oh, Mo Bear.
Oh, God. Oh.
Leave me alone. Oh, there he comes. Oh, he's going
to. He's like, he's deciding whether he wants to invest and actually stand up.
Yeah.
I missed the wig. I kind of don't because it's so hot. Why F8 instead of SF90? It's an SP, but SF.
Well, I'll be honest with you. I don't know if that whole hybrid thing does it for me. I know it's a lot of horsepower. I know
it's also expensive.
Yeah, it's expensive. It starts starting at 500.
It's starting price is a half.
It's
a million.
A production line car, so there's nothing special about it. So I don't mind paying $300 to $400. I'm not going to pay $500,000 for it. If I'm going to pay $500,000, I'm going to go and get the Especiale.
Especiale?
Yeah, the Especiale.
Yes.
Yeah. Or Especiale Aperta, which there is like $600. I mean, there's nothing. I mean,
it's but then you can't really drive them. Because they're worth too much.
So what? Just drive it. It's okay.
You would kill the value of that thing.
Oh, what?
A Speciale.
What?
Are we
talking about his F8?
No, the 458.
Look, do I even drive my 458 right now?
True.
Yeah. Barely. I don't drive it enough. I mean, I'm like that. Not because I don't want to, but I'm just like that. I don't know. I drive the van.
You're busy.
Yeah, I'm busy. And
he also has like a busy life.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's the problem with, I think, a lot of these very successful people who end up being in positions to buy these cars that are extremely expensive is their work life takes over and they two things happen. One, their work life is set up so that they just don't have time.
Yeah.
Or two, they end up buying so many cars that literally they can't like drive all the cars.
Right.
So.
Rust Belt said 812 Superfast. Well, Rust Belt.
Those are badass.
Let me tell you a story about an 812 Superfast in my neighborhood. I almost got run over by one. I'm taking my dogs for a walk. And I yelled out at that guy to slow down.
Slow down!
And he puts his hand out like this. Okay, fine. And then like about, I don't know, maybe about 3 or 4 months later when I had my car, he actually saw me and he drives by. He's like, yeah, he's like this. And he's like, yeah, I'm like, yeah, there you go. So it's pretty tight now.
Oh, someone asked, are your V-dubs air cooled?
Yes.
All of them?
Yeah.
You got older ones, right?
Yeah. Well, I can tell you what they are if you really want to know.
Might as well.
There are people who appreciate these things.
Yeah. We got general car people.
Yeah, there you go. Okay. Now, if anyone...
Real quick, F12 TDF is badass.
Oh, yeah, that's a good car.
But I don't know what that
so
is.
So expensive. They're like 1.1, 1.2.
We saw one at CNC, didn't we?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, no, that one was sick.
Oh, it was. Especially it had all the carbon fiber paneling and around the engine.
It had blue carbon.
Blue carbon.
It was custom ordered.
It was custom ordered.
Blue carbon.
Yeah, it was unbelievable.
Sick as
Unbelievable. Oh, look at that. Blue Paul carbon. Says the BB512.
No.
That's kind of a little bit of a ratty car.
Zing!
But I like it. But I'm not interested in that car.
I think we have to actually, we have to distance ourselves from that car for a while.
Yes, because only one guy makes that.
There's only one person on the internet
for one person that can buy that car.
No. Nobody, like, okay, two dudes on the internet cannot possibly be contemplating purchasing a car simultaneously.
Right.
No. It's illegal.
Yes. No can do. But
it creates a tear in the space-time continuum.
Yes.
And
so let me just clarify something for everyone. Dan's spoken about this before. It is not a fixer-upper project car that we're looking for. No. We are, however, interested in putting LM parts and converting it to an LM with like some really
big
cool big brakes and awesome suspension components and everything.
The LM wing.
Which we're hoping to be able to videotape and show you. That's our whole intent.
Video team.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
I know. I'm old too.
I say that shit too.
We're going to use the camcorder and videotape it, convert it to digital, and then put it on the internet. All for you. So that's what our plans are. We're not looking to find a messed up F40.
Yeah.
Because neither Dan or I have the cojones to go and do something like that.
And frankly, it's a losing proposition.
It is. And once like people know the history on that car, they just don't.
When you do the math on these wrecked F40s, it's just stupid. It's absolutely stupid.
Yeah. So. And we don't own a vacuum press, so we can't do any carbon fiber or fiberglass work. Sorry. You know, we're looking to upgrade it and do some cool stuff, you know, possibly make a custom fab speed exhaust for it.
Page me when those videotapes are ready for viewing.
who is that? Is it?
I'll call you on Zach Morris's brick phone.
Oh, page me. Oh, I have to make sure that I'm in an area that's pager friendly.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on. Oh, they put 911. This is important.
Or no, remember when they used to do boobless?
800-7355.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
So that's our intent with it. That's what we want to do. We're not going on any scavenger hunt or anything like that. We're going to buy it from somebody, and it's going to be in a location. We think.
Someone said mini parking spot just got upgraded to a vacuum press.
Oh gosh.
I can kick anybody out of my house at any time.
There you go.
Someone wanted the F430 update, and I've been kind of radio silent on it.
Oh, by the way, what a clean car.
Oh yeah.
I mean, wow.
Dude,
to the point where I said, hey, if something happens here, I want a possibility of a crack at it, because that is really clean. I mean, the interior is beautiful. The paint, and I'm not just trying to sell this car off and everything, because it's already spoken.
The car is sold.
Yeah, this car is spoken for already. But if that gentleman, if you're out there, good job. This is a nice car.
No, I think it's one of the best.
Beautiful.
It's seriously one of the cleanest F430s I've ever seen.
The engine bay is phenomenal.
Yes, rest assured, guy who bought the F430. Wait, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, F430. I have not been able to park in the garage since that car's been there. Your car is safe. My Mini Cooper is exposed to the elements.
Oh. Yes.
So the 430 is still in the garage, still here, because of COVID. So the previous owner who we bought it from had a lien on the car. It had a loan. We paid off that loan, and we still do not have the title. So it's taken over 2 months to get the damn title to us.
Right.
So obviously he can't buy the car from us until we have a title to give him.
Yes.
So we're waiting for the title. We got notification from the banking company that the loan's been paid off, and we still don't have the title. So we're waiting for the title, and hopefully it'll be here any day now. And then he can pay me off. And then once we get paid off, believe it or not, I initially said this publicly. I said, anyone, oh, thank you, Mousetrap.
Thank you, Mousetrap. Oh, Mousetrap. I didn't see Mousetrap tonight.
He is awesome. You've been kind of quiet. What a good guy.
So once we get the car paid off, he actually has been talking about doing some upgrades to the car before it gets shipped out. So,
naturally, I won't get my parking spot till like August.
No. Once the car is paid off, it'll probably be about a week and a half.
Okay.
Is my guess. So anyway.
Whatever.
So maybe.
I think he honestly believes that. So I'm going to let it ride.
I'm hoping for that. I want the car.
I think Dan believes these things when he says them.
So lessons learned, I will tell you.
Oh, Rachel.
Kent likes watching Grey's Anatomy. So mean.
Oh.
I love it. So lesson learned here is the next project car we do, I'm going to make sure it doesn't have a lien on it because of time, how long it takes to just deal with all that. Or I'm going to set the expectations that, like, the car is going to be here for...
Doesn't someone having a lien on a car imply that they were in bad straits? No.
No, it means they have a loan.
Yeah.
Oh.
If you don't have a, even on a home, if
your car,
have a mortgage,
my note, car has, well, yeah, my car doesn't, but your car has a lien on it.
My Mini Cooper?
Yes, because we have a loan on it.
You know what's a better?
That's not a lien.
Yes, it is.
Oh, I thought it's just like a loan you're paying off is different from a lien. It's like.
No, they call it a lien.
Yeah. On mortgage, they can usually call it a note.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have a mortgage. They should call it a car note.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
Well, I mean, anytime I hear lien is when you don't pay a contractor and they put
and
a lien
somebody,
on your house.
Yes.
So you can
exactly.
do that. But that's something they can do.
Having a lien on something implied that
here's the thing.
Defaulted on something else.
Well, if you do default on the car, here
the bank owns it.
Yeah, and they'll try to repossess it.
Yeah.
Instead of foreclosing on it. So.
So saying lien is the same as saying loan? Doesn't seem right.
Well, a lien is a claim against property.
Gary!
What, Gary?
Gary!
What did you say?
Meg, I'm concerned that the KISS shirt looks like you slept at Jeff's last night. And you have on his hair tie.
What a rock and roll. Oh, man.
Well, if I slept at Jeff's last night,
hilarious.
I'd never be satisfied by another man.
Oh, wow. That is a hell of a compliment.
Jeff, I just got to ask this once. Why are you not coming, Omar, for Pain and Suffering to F40 purchase?
Stop giving $2 to this effort. Oh. You have given blood, sweat, and tears to this endeavor, which is like a circus.
Jeff, you need to call Doug. I actually got a text from David because David can't go. And there's a spot available.
There's spots for you, Jeff.
There's a spot, Jeff. You need to come.
Oh, Jeff.
He's the only
one.
Oh, man.
Jeff with the good hair in the
355.
The good hair. Good hair, Jeff.
He uses the same shampoo and conditioner as I do.
Does he really?
Yeah.
That's probably why his hair is very nice.
He's got beautiful hair.
He does have
absolutely
nice hair.
Gorgeous.
Very nice hair.
Sunset, I'm not sure, Dan. The 458 is a heck of a car, 50% more expensive, but the jump to from F430 to 458 is more than 50%, in my opinion. I agree. No, I think like I said, if you can afford the 458, it is worth it to get the 458 over the 430. But if you can't afford the 458 and you go buy a 430, you are not going to be disappointed. It is an amazing car.
It's got a lot of character.
It does. Yeah. It is a beautiful, amazing car. And for under $100,000, I don't think there's anything else on the market that is as good in the around $100,000 price point.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Fred's hair isn't too shabby.
No, Fred has lovely hair.
I got terrible hair. I got screwed.
You guys didn't see his hair in the day.
Back in the day, I actually had really good hair.
Beautiful hair.
But it all fell out in my late 20s.
I had a little bit of my hair fall out recently, too.
It doesn't look it. It
doesn't look it compared to me.
No, like the,
Oh, yeah.
When you got to deal with something, you know?
Yes. I'm not going to be hung around sharing a room. We're sharing a room.
You know, if he's legitimately got concerns
I get it.
Then
yeah.
Leave him alone.
No, I'm not going to pressure you. A little. Sort of. Okay, maybe a little bit. Someone's getting laid tonight. Nah.
Anyway. Mo.
Yeah. Yeah.
Moses.
The little doggy next door.
If you enjoy the track, at least once with the F40 on the track is a must. I kind of agree.
Yeah.
It's got it. Just because. That's like a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Twice.
Hey,
Bianca! She was shooting by that, dude, she means photographs. An M3 in Dripping Springs.
She has like gotten some seriously awesome...
Beautiful pictures recently.
Beautiful pictures recently.
What is Bianca's social media content?
What's your Instagram, Bianca?
Bianca! Shout out your Instagram or Facebook or whatever.
Yeah.
Snapchat, TikTok, what have you.
TikTok.
We're so in.
What is that TikTok?
It's for middle schoolers.
Oh, is that bullshit? That's that Charlie D'Amelio. She does this.
Oh, it is Boost and Barbell.
Boost and Barbell.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Everybody sign up to Bianca's Instagram. Bianca. She does excellent car pornography.
She does.
If you are interested.
Yes. Don't you lose having insurance at the track? You can purchase auxiliary insurance.
It's incredibly expensive.
For a car like the F40, you're going to.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no way in hell you're going to go track an F40 without buying insurance.
And I'm like my dad. I love insurance.
I love insurance.
Yeah, it's great.
My dad has weird insurances for shit that never happens.
Dude, her dad, legit.
Yeah.
When her mom and Megan, her mom, went to...
We flew to Europe together somewhere.
He insured the flight.
No. He insured their bodies.
Oh, yeah, the flight. You insured the flight.
No, he insured their bodies if they died, that they would ship their bodies home.
Oh, really?
Because it's apparently very expensive to ship a body internationally.
I was like, really?
So my father had insurance on our bodies.
Yeah.
Wow.
I was like, what?
I mean this sincerely. My father loves us very much, but, like, that's just some neurotic... Shit.
I hate to talk about this, but isn't a dead body considered a pathogen?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's probably why. And in some countries,
it's expensive.
Yeah.
It's expensive.
Yeah. Yeah.
He had a valid point. It's like tens of thousands of dollars.
Yeah.
But it was like, come on. Like, if you die in a foreign country.
If you think about it, though, Dad, like the fact if me and my mom kick it both early, you're going to save so much money.
It's like
it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
So morbid. Sorry.
Yeah.
But yeah, he did insure our bodies.
Yeah.
Like in case we died outside the country.
Our food's been picked up.
Not very good.
Yeah. It's good. When's it going to be here? Oh, they're on their way. Oh, man. We may have to end the live earlier for food comes.
Sorry, I got eight.
Yeah, sorry. Sorry, we got Thai food.
You're all SOL.
This is serious business.
Yeah.
All right.
Chopsticks and stuff.
Yeah. Thai food's amazing.
It's unbelievable.
Oh, somebody in Toronto said your reviews were really, really helpful to him. He has a 4:30 now.
Well, thank you. I try. Where was that?
Oh. At the top.
Yeah, there it is. You're welcome. I try. Not always the best, but when is NGS Coda track day going to be? I would join.
As soon as Coda's like, we're ready to have our NGS track day.
Yeah. I mean, the problem with I can't do like a straight up NGS track day because that's like to rent out Coda costs over $50,000. And
is that like just for the day?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yeah, so they do make money.
No.
Oh, only on when they rent it out for the whole day.
They still don't make.
Oh yeah. Well.
It costs more to operate Coda than $50,000 a day.
Oh, once you start doing a track day, they have to have like flag workers and.
Do they need like medical personnel?
Yeah, and all this crap. So it gets really expensive.
And a lot of fire extinguishers.
Oh, here you go, Fred. F40 over the F50, and why?
V8, no V12. And, you know, to me, the F40 is an iconic car. I just like it more.
The F40 underperforms the F50.
No, the F50 underperforms the F40.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, excuse me. You're right. Sorry.
Yeah.
But, like, yeah, the F50, which was the later car, paradoxically underperformed to the F40. So why would you buy the underperforming car? I mean, I suppose there's less
of
them, but probably for a reason.
I think a lot of it's the look. Like, so there's a few things. One, the F40 was the last car that Enzo signed off on.
Yeah.
Which I think people put value on, which is stupid, but okay, there's something there. The F50 has a very peculiar look. It's a very distinct car in the Ferrari lineup. Like, nothing looks like the F50.
Oh, yeah.
And personally, the F50 is a weird convertible, not a convertible.
Well, it's a Barchetta, isn't it?
So it's a soft top, removable top.
Yeah.
Which I personally think looks horrifying. Yeah. Like, if you've seen the F50 LM cars, those are sick as hell. That's how it should have been. That's how you could have, if that is how it could have looked for a normal consumer, that would have been badass. But
and lastly, it's very expensive.
Yeah, they're $3+ million. Yeah,
sorry, I don't got money like that. Yeah,
I've got $1 million money.
Yeah, I got $1 million. I've got three.
$3 million. That's a huge difference.
Yeah, that's just a lot of money.
It is. Yeah. It's crazy.
If we had the means, would we? Yeah, we keep collecting. Why not?
Yeah, sure. Because you're going to make money on that car. Yeah. No, you can make money on it. You buy it for three, you wait 3 years, and you sell it for five.
And you put them in a garage, and you walk in there and say, hello, ladies.
Yeah. No, you're getting free financial advice here, guys. Like, suck it up. Absorb it. Yeah.
Fred drove here. Yes, he did.
Fred drove here.
He drove here 20 hours straight.
Plumma Man 13. What up, Fred? Hey, what's up, Plumma Man?
Plumma Man.
Hey, Plumma Man.
Oh, gosh.
Let's see. What else we got?
Austin is too much money.
I mean, it's expensive here. It's not cheap.
It is not a cheap cost of living here. It's not as bad as some places, but it has gotten worse.
What did Fred drive, Fred?
Oh, a 2020... convertible Mustang V6 EcoBoo.
Yeah.
EcoBoost.
You rented that, right?
Yeah. Well, I didn't even want that. I wanted a compact vehicle. And they're like, oh, yeah, we don't have any of those because of the, you know, what's going on. And people, you know, we're not, you know, okay, fine. What do you have? We got this car.
Cheers to you, Bianca.
Cheers, Bianca.
Why is Meg's glass empty?
It's not empty anymore.
True. Oh, do you need more?
Oh, yeah, sure. Just a little. Not too much.
We're drinking the French
just
wine now.
That's fine.
Red's like, whoa, heavy hand there, buddy.
Destroy the bottle. The bottle has been destroyed.
Yeah.
Gotta get as much as I can.
So it's not a bad car. I raced Dan today.
Yeah.
I lost handily.
Red, you gotta try my mini. Have you driven a mini?
I have.
Okay, good.
But I haven't driven the turbocharged.
Oh, you need to drive it. It's fun.
I bet it's really nice. I think
James is very.
James drove it.
Who's James?
A big guy.
Big man.
Yeah.
And he fit. He said he was comfortable.
You know, they have a lot of room.
It does.
Yeah.
It does.
It's shockingly a lot of cool cars. Yeah.
Especially the John Cooper Works edition.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But even without the turbo, it was pretty zippy. I liked it.
Yeah. No, like, I love my car. I love my car. So people, like, on the channel always ask me, like, what's your dream car? It's like, first of all, with my excess time, I don't dream about cars. I dream about other things. If I dream about material objects, it's probably like, oh, I want that jacket from that place. But.
Or shoes.
You're
not a big shoe person.
Not huge, but. It won't be a car that I'm dreaming about if I'm spending my excess time dreaming about things. But I love my Mini. Like, my Mini feels like I feel at home in it. I feel at one with it.
It's a nice color.
I love my Mini.
Chili red.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's spicy.
Chili red, guys.
Gucci. Gucci what?
Gucci with the I or with the Y?
No, it's not a Gucci. I don't own anything Gucci, guys. I tend to avoid conspicuous branding altogether.
It's Meg, it's like the fake Ferraris. It's not a Ferrari with an I, it's with a Y.
Ferrari.
There was actually, believe it or not, I'm just going to touch on this real quick. There was actually a company on the internet that was supposedly selling these fake cars. And I don't remember what they were called, but they were made, I think they were made in Brazil. And people would actually send them money, and they would show the real car. And people actually send them money, and they would not produce anything, just take their money. So
Rachel's right. I do have one nice pair of shoes that, lots of nice shoes, but I have one stupid expensive pair of shoes that my husband bought me 1 year for my birthday, and they are red bottoms. Yes. And I only break them out on very nice occasions.
The Louboutins?
Yeah.
I have one pair. One pair, guys.
That was when I was doing pretty good, and every life was pretty nice, and we could be like, hey, we have some money to blow.
And they're very well taken care of. They sit inside their velvet bag, inside their box on the top shelf, and they only come out for very special occasions.
Yeah. Someone asked, are you going to have to pull the engine on the F40? So believe it or not, the F40, you do not have to pull the engine to do a major. It actually has a
clamshell and an access panel.
The clamshell, and it actually has an access panel. So, yeah, you don't have to pull the engine to do the major. So it's unlikely that the engine will have to be pulled for that car. Yes.
Hey, Rachel gave you an A++++. That's a great grade.
I just popped my collar.
Because last week I got a C-. And, you know, I still got the highest grade at what I was doing. She's like, what were you doing, Fred?
Have you guys talked about Rachel and Meg driving school in the vet?
It'll happen. It seems like that's a good idea.
Okay, let me mention something.
Yes.
If you really want to learn how to drive a manual or stick shift.
I think the universe wants me to learn more than I do.
But you know what's really easy to learn on? Scott, if you're watching this, your Volkswagen. It is, you can't stall that thing. It's so easy to throw out the clutch. Everything is just so easy to just grab. You can literally take off by just lifting the clutch. Mm-hmm. And it's just Volkswagen engines are very torquey on that engagement. So,
and it's I don't know what any of that means.
Yeah. Well, if we were to explain it to you, you'd be all like, oh yeah, that's easy.
No, there's an additional pedal. Like, what's that about?
Someone asked
if houses in Austin have basements. No, because you would have to dynamite them out of the limestone. Yeah. There's no basements here.
Plumber Man, Dan Fred, have you guys seen that company from Argentina that makes the replica Bugattis and Maseratis? They're replica cars from the 30s?
Nope, not heard of them.
Mm-hmm. No.
Well,
would have made for good views if you had to pull edge, but it's still going to be awesome to watch. I agree. I mean, yeah, it'll be fun.
If we need to in order to fix something.
Yeah, but it's unlikely. But
no.
Like, why?
If we had to rebuild the transaxle?
It's probably going to be Josh that does this work. And I'm sure as someone who's professionally knowledgeable, he doesn't want to pull an engine on an F40 unless it's absolutely necessary.
Right.
That doesn't mean, because then you've got somebody else's incredibly expensive asset that you're responsible for.
Right.
No, but I trust
Josh.
That's
scary.
Yeah.
He knows what he's doing.
He does.
Yeah.
Josh.
No, I'm not saying anything about Josh. I'm going to be like, why would you pull an engine out
unnecessarily?
Of that?
Oh, yeah, unnecessarily.
Yeah, why would you do more work than you have to?
Yeah, maybe the most craziest thing would be if we had a main seal leaking.
Then you might have, if you got like some seal leaking or something,
you might have to take it apart and everything. But those things don't leak that easily.
No, generally not.
Yeah, they get 100,000 miles out of them.
My wife is very impressed, Dan, about the red bottom. She didn't hear the stream. Hey, it was, like I said, this was back when I was doing well. And I really wanted to be, Meg deserves nice things. And
nobody needs a pair of shoes like that.
True.
That was a very extra thing to buy.
It was.
I love my husband. That was very nice. But like, honestly, I only need one pair of red bottoms because my lifestyle doesn't incorporate a lot of occasions where you need to put on red bottoms.
True.
Like, what am I going to do? Yeah. Like, I go to weddings and like fancy things like
once in a while,
a handful of times a year.
Yeah. Someone asked, will it have PPF? Will you add it
to what?
The F40.
Where it's needed. I mean, I don't really think I want to saran wrap the whole car, but I mean, I don't know. The front, maybe. I don't know. We'll have to see. We'll have to take it on a case-by-case basis, and we have to see what Brad recommends, huh?
Oh, our food's here.
I'll get it. You guys continue your thing.
Okay, all right. We'll probably wrap it up pretty quick here because, I mean, Thai food.
Yeah, I mean, chopsticks.
Thai food. It's the shiz. All right, so we'll take one or two more questions. What do you guys think of the
guys,
F40?
Ask questions about the F8 or the F40, because that's what's going on.
What do you guys think of the F40 that Gas Monkey did? I don't know. I didn't really watch any of that.
You mean the whole rebuild?
The black one.
Oh.
I don't know.
But it wasn't black. They painted it black, right?
Yeah,
because it had significant, like, aesthetic issues, so they painted it black, right?
Yeah. No, it was a trash car.
It's great if that's your thing.
Yeah, I don't.
But like we said, I mean, we're not going to do paint bodywork unless it really needs it.
Right.
We're not going to restore a car. That's just...
When you start talking about redoing the body and the paint work on the F40, that's where you want a professional garage.
Yeah.
And guys, that's very cool, the people who do that. But Dan is normal guy.
Yes.
We're not doing that in the cul-de-sac.
Yes.
Okay? That's not what's going on here.
Right.
What did y'all order from Madam Mam's? I got the Gary Curry chicken. And Meg and Fred both got the fried rice with pork.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, she's
adorable.
Yeah,
it's here. All right. Woo-hoo. We'll answer two more questions.
Two more questions.
Just answer them as long as they're good.
Give me a good F8 question.
Yeah, F8.
Yeah, let's talk about the F8.
We also got satay and something else. But yeah. Mm.
They just left it there.
Yeah.
Say, do you know
how I got damaged?
Yeah.
How it? What? It what?
We ran into what? And
you're talking about the black F40. I don't know. I have no idea. I don't watch that.
Oh,
stuff.
He's like, why F8 over Pista?
Oh.
The Pista
is a lot more expensive.
It's a lot more expensive. I would love to have a Pista. However, you know. You have to be invited to buy those cars.
We don't have a date for the F8. You haven't even submitted the allocation yet.
So you guys are probably going to see a video here very soon that we're going to, when we do the specifying, there's possibly even going to be a spider that Dan is going to review prior.
Yeah.
We already talked to them and they said, yeah, no problem. So there's still a little bit of footwork to be done, and we hope you all enjoy.
F8 question: are you excited to have the Pista engine?
Yes, it does. Yeah, it has the Pista engine, but it does not have the Pista suspension.
Yeah, and it's not different. The same exhaust either.
It's not the same exhaust. Yeah,
it's not as loud.
Yeah,
But Pista actually does sound a little bit better.
Yeah,
but either way, the exhaust is still kind of tame.
Yeah.
On both of them, it just. Yeah.
We're hoping to open that up.
Yeah, it needs a no cats.
Yeah, exactly. That would be better.
You need to register it in Texas.
Yes, that's for sure. Sorry, Gavin. I'm not paying your yearly registration fees.
All right. Any...
The F8 on paper looks like it should match or outperform the Pista. Just don't hold the value like a Pista.
Yeah, well.
Look, there are certain cars. I mean, if you're really worried about maintaining, you see something funny?
Yeah, she said, have we already covered the clock questions?
Oh, gosh. Okay.
Here's the clock maker.
It's right there.
Hi, it's me. I'm the crazy idiot that sits there and makes that thing. Yeah. So they're cool. Yeah. If anybody wants us to do a special run on them, to sell, it's not gonna be cheap. You may not want to pay for it, but if anybody wants to plop down like $5 or $6 for one, we might consider it.
Our neighbor.
Hey, what's up, Porter?
Porter.
What's up, Porter?
Dan, do a shout-out.
Chudley, if you are into trains, you should go watch Chudley and his YouTube
really,
channel.
Really, really cool.
He is my neighbor down the street at the end of the cul-de-sac. All right.
Does the F8 come in a manual transmission?
No.
They don't have any more manual transmissions.
Yeah, no more.
Unless you get it and you modify it.
Yep.
Which is a pain in the dick.
What do you think? I think we're good.
Yeah.
We got to eat. So, okay, guys. Thank you. Thank you so much. We did our job. We destroyed this bottle of wine. We now have food. Oh, wait. We got to
drink
the rest of it.
Cheers. Hopefully, we'll give you some good updates.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Stay tuned. And... Ooh. We're going to do it.
Damn it. There was some sediment in there.
Oh, you mean from?
I'll get the last of the bottle.
Oh, that's actually good stuff.
I hate the sediment.
You know that's good luck.
To drink the sediment?
Yes.
It tastes like butt. I hate that.
You were the last pour.
Look how bad that is.
You were the last pour, right?
That went in my mouth.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah.
That's all right. All right, guys. Well.
All right. Good night, everybody.
Good night. Thanks for watching. More car stuff. It's going to be sweet. Don't expect any videos for a while. All right. Bye.
Night.